This video is about what's in the very near future of anti-aging science. And if you're in your 50s, it's really, really exciting. So if you'd like to know more, please keep watching. This is my son, Nathan. He's 23 and he researches everything. But at the moment, he's down the rabbit hole researching longevity. So if you're a woman in your 50s, this is some really exciting stuff because he's told me a whole lot about what the scientists are doing with anti-aging. So Nathan, tell us all what's happening because I'm excited.
Yeah, Shell, it's absolutely amazing. I've always been researching a little bit of this and a little bit of that, but the more I find out about the technology coming out about anti-aging, it is blowing me away. Ray Kurzweil said that we're adding 1.1 years to the life expectancy every year at the moment. And that means every year you age, your life expectancy goes up by another 1.1 years. Well, they say they're going to be able to add 30 to 40 good years of life within the next 10 years.
Wow.
So if you're 50 at the moment, it's not unreasonable that you'd be living to 150.
That kind of seems unrealistic, but I know that you're doing the research and it's very realistic.
Yeah, well, the things that are driving it is you can now have your human genome sequenced for less than $1,000. So what that means is you can look at your software and say, oh, okay, cool, I've got a really dangerous cancer that might crop up in the next couple of years. Let's deal with that now.
And how would you deal with that?
Well, at the moment, you can take steps when you know that there's a problem that could come up. You can take steps to prevent it.
Right.
But the really exciting thing is once it gets a little bit better, this technology of sequencing and analyzing genes, you're going to be able to edit out genes.
So you could edit out a cancer gene,
an
arthritis gene.
You could delete a stupid gene.
You
could make yourself brown hair instead of blonde.
Really?
You could. Yeah, absolutely.
So how does that work?
DNA is basically the software code. If you can understand it well enough, you can then go and edit it, which is where we're heading.
So for a woman in her 50s, are we kind of going to be the first ones to try this?
Yeah, so the people...
That's actually going to make a difference? Because there's no point in doing any of this when you're young. Like, it's us.
Of course. All of this stuff that I'm talking about is not perfected yet, but the things that are going to benefit you now, today, already here, is stem cell therapy.
Which is?
Which is anyone with back problems, anyone with skin problems, anyone with bad knees, bad elbows, any issues.
Aging? Wrinkles?
Absolutely. If you put stem cells on your face, you can regenerate beautiful baby skin.
How?
At the moment...
How? I have seen the video, but tell us how.
So I'm not an expert on any of this at all, just an enthusiast.
Enthusiast, yeah.
But stem cells basically are the building blocks to everything that makes a human a human. So if you can get blank stem cells that don't have any characteristics of who you are now and add them into your system,
right,
they will refresh and become the most optimal version of whatever should be there.
So if you're already aging, like, you know, you just say for me with my skin, could I get baby skin?
At the moment, it's expensive, but you could do it. But very soon, for the same amount it's going to cost you, go get a face, you'll be able to grow a full set of new skin on your face.
Really? That's so exciting.
No.
Really? I can't even imagine how exciting that would be for all of us. And we're not taking the baby placenta or the cells out of the
Just to give some context for everybody.
Because I know that's...
A good way to find stem cells is from a baby placenta. Shirley wasn't just...
Yeah. That is what they've spoken about, and I don't like that.
What they can do now is take out your blood.
Yep.
Put it in a machine, take the stem cells out, put the rest of the blood back in, and then use the stem cells where they're needed.
Okay.
But once this technology gets a little bit better, it's only a couple of years away, they'll be able to grow ideal stem cells and you'll be able to just get a pop wherever you
just
need.
Just get a pop.
It'll be just like going to have Panadol.
Women in our age group, we can realistically live for another 30 years after 100.
Well, they say...
Another 30%.
They say that my kids are going to be the last generation of people to die, period. But people your age are realistically going to be able to expect to live to 150.
And this is the people on the leading edge of science and technology.
Yeah, so people like Diamandis, Ray Kurzweil, all of these people that are developing this technology. At the moment, it's very expensive. That's why a lot of people haven't heard of it.
Yep.
But they can do these things now.
And will it be affordable for everybody in 10 years' time?
Oh, absolutely. Not,
because now
not
it's
perhaps
like...
living forever, but growing yourself a new set of skin, absolutely. New hair, new teeth.
Really?
You go get yourself a tune-up.
Really? Tune-up?
Take your car to the mechanic. And you...
okay, so stem cell, what else? What else is going to help with anti-aging? And feeling good and repairing sore muscles and all that.
Stem cells and the genes are the huge things that are going to really change everything.
Okay.
I don't think you understand. It's not like a one thing to fix this, one thing to fix this. There are certain technologies coming out that are going to be able to say, okay, you can stay in your prime forever. You can...
And in your prime means you're going to feel good, feel healthy,
lots of
feel
energy,
vital.
Healthy skin, healthy body, healthy everything, brain activity working well.
That's so exciting. No loss of memory.
No loss of memory. You're going to be able to have a chip very soon.
I know, but that freaks a lot of people out. It freaks me out, having a chip.
Yeah, it freaks you out. But if you said to someone in the 90s, we're going to give you this oracle of information that will tell you anything that you can think of. Any question you can think to ask it, it will know the answer to.
Right.
But the trade-off is you need to let it know all your private information. It'll know everything about you and all of your secrets.
Right.
People would say, no, I wouldn't do it.
Yeah,
I want my privacy.
They would say
that.
But
every day they go to Google and they type in all their deepest, darkest concerns and fantasies.
Yep.
Google knows who you are, what you're searching, and we're okay with that because the benefits are so good.
Yeah, it's but Google actually knows every single thing about us, doesn't it?
Yeah, Google
knows everything.
Google's had issues before where they know people's search history and their personality so well. They're having a philosophical dilemma at the moment. They know when people are going to commit suicide and if it's a cry for help or a real thing, and they're trying to decide whether it's something that they intervene with or not. But that's already here now.
This technology is here now, but it's going to have exponential growth, which means it's going to happen very, very, very quickly compared to what we're used to.
Yeah. Phones are getting smaller and smaller and smaller and more efficient and thinner and better, and everything about them is becoming ultra efficient. The phone itself is going to disappear. And you're still going to have your phone, but instead of phones, it's going to be a contact lens or an implant. Like if you can think of wearing a contact lens.
I don't know if I'd get an implant.
Yeah, but you would say, I don't know if I'd let that big evil company know all my private details either. But then you get there and you see all the benefits.
If I have a phone.
Yes.
If I have a phone, it's like having an implant because my phone.
Yeah, you
can
outsource your thinking to you know, give you a boost of capability.
Oh, is that what I'm doing?
When you use your phone, you're taking what your brain power can do and combining it with this. So instead of having two devices, you just have one now.
Wow. And you also said with the anti-aging kind of science research they're doing, you can make yourself smarter.
Absolutely.
So how will that work? Will that just be a stem cell?
Well, at the moment, if you do enough reading or learning or studying or experience or whatever, you can teach yourself anything.
Right. Can you? Can everybody teach themselves? Because you might not be smart enough to process it all and remember it all.
The way to get smarter, at the moment, you can make yourself smarter. That's
yep,
no problem.
Sure.
But if you can, say, add triple the processing speed of your brain, triple the information consumption capability, you know, if you can, instead of reading one book and it takes you a week, you can consume all the relevant information in any subject instantly and assimilate it and be able to use it. You could have all the knowledge of all the doctors in all of history ever.
How far away is that?
20 years?
20 years.
Less?
So
but by the time you get to 20 years, you're still going to look probably around 50.
Yeah, and we'll have another, if we're going to live to 130, 20 years is going to be not so far away.
Yeah, the way it's going, people are going to stop dying very soon.
But then what are we going to do with all the people? So that's another bigger dilemma.
That's a bigger dilemma.
But the point is that the researchers now have this technology for rejuvenation and longevity. It's longevity. And I know that the they've coined the term 100 is the new 60.
You'll still be able to do everything at 100 that you can do at 60.
That's pretty insane.
Like, by the time you get to 100, you don't have to wait till I can have the benefits. By the time you get to 100, everything you can do now, you'll still be able to do.
You'll still be able to think, run, exercise, box. Do you think you can still box?
Does everybody know that? Shelley's a boxing master.
I hurt my wrist, so I don't know if I can box. Stop it.
So you can bleep it out.
I'll bleep that out. How exciting.
That's so exciting.
For you as a young person, it's exciting because you'll be, who knows what's going to happen for you, but for us, it's like, we don't have to, nothing has to go downhill. Like we're programmed to believe everything goes downhill, but actually that's so not true.
Yeah. The news is telling everybody everything's so bad, but when I grew up, there was no Instagram, no virtual reality, nothing.
Computers.
My friends and I, we went to school, got trained for these jobs, and now people in marketing, creating sales funnels and social media analysts, these jobs didn't exist when we were coming up. And this is only in 10 years. What's going to happen is going to be nothing like what's already happened.
No. It's exciting and it's scary.
But it's more exciting, isn't it? Much more exciting.
If it's going to be made available to everybody and something that we can all do,
there's going to be no downhill.
It's only going to be...
The idea is, once you get artificial intelligence that can build things on its own, it will be able to solve every problem that we can think of. Everything that's an issue now or anything that's on any level a problem or an impediment to your happiness is going to be dealt with straight away. No more sore back, no more loss of concentration, no more nothing.
Within 10 years?
10, 20 years for sure.
10 or 20 years. Wow. Okay, that's really exciting. Thank you, Nathan.
Thank you, Mom.
That's awesome. Okay, have a great day.